Wow, I can't believe it's Pastor Appreciation Day again. You know, we're sitting around here and we're talking about mom and dad or whatever. And you know, one thing that I wonder what was dad's first words when he seen mom? What did he say to her?
And I said, hey, pretty lady, won't you give me a sign? I'd give anything to make you mine or mine. I'll do your bidding and be at your beck and call. Yeah, I've never seen anyone looking so fine. Man, I gotta have her, she's a one of a kind. I'm going once, going twice. I'm so lonely.
Hey, speaking of that, you know, look at it the other side. What do you think mom's first words were to dad?
I couldn't even imagine.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. My.
If dad could say one thing to mom, what do you think it would be?
Woman, the beautifulest woman in the whole wide world. A woman that I love, a woman that I appreciate. If I get sick, I want her to pray for me because I know how she lives. The best y'all can find, but I found the very best one. Somebody said, that's in your opinion. Well, that's the way it's supposed to be. It's in my opinion. And to me, my opinion is the only one that counts to me. And I thank God I found the love of my life. And I thank God for a wife that stood by me in ministry, a wife that stood by me in times that I didn't know what I was going to do. Walk in and tell me, hold on, Jesus will see you through. And I thank God for a woman of faith that she is.
Just seems like yesterday beautiful, and you still, so is, God's blessed me with the most beautiful wife there is.
Rocking right beside me, every day that passes, I only love her more.
Hallelujah, I look at my wife and I say, how in the world can you look so good, you look so young, and be a grandparent?
Everything I ever wanted, everything I need, she's
How do y'all think that mom deals with, like, the thoughts of being in the ministry, you know, like having to deal with so much of the responsibility and stuff?
Yeah, like, just, it is a lot. It's a lot, and to wonder what she's thinking.
I want to ask you a question. What kind of legacy do you want to leave your kids? Do you want a legacy of them being the president of the United States? Do you want to leave them a legacy of them being a movie star or the richest person in the world? Or do you want to leave them a legacy of faith, teaching them what God is for, what God is about? That's something I think and I hope that I have passed down the faith to my kids. When I was going through my storm, when the devil told me that I had breast cancer, you know, I'd go to doctor after doctor. And every doctor I'd go to, they'd tell me, you've got breast cancer. They would do mammograms. They did biopsies after biopsy. And then at the end, the doctor said, they did the last biopsy. And he says, no, you don't have cancer. And I said, praise God. I came to church and I gave my testimony that I was healed of breast cancer, and the devil got mad. The very next day, the doctor called me and says, you've got to come in for surgery because the cancer is there and you've got to come in. Pastor Steve and I, every day, a day did not go by that we did not take communion. Did the surgery on me, and they promised my husband there'd be just a small little place. They cut me all the way and I went back. He told my husband, he says, I know there's something there. And when I went back, he looked at me and he told me, he says, I knew there was something there. The reason we put you through what we put you through, he says, because what you had is always cancer. He said, and I don't know what happened. I said, I know what happened. God stepped in and took over.
And now I know for sure. I feel provided now, so I don't worry anymore.
I can remember when Sister Willine, just 2 years ago, she had cancer in her breast, and the doctors had found it, and you know, they went back and they examined it, and they done a biopsy, and it was there, and that we prayed and believed and anointed with oil, and Hallelujah. And her final test was that she was healed. Glory to God. And you know, 1 year prior to that, I had a tumor on my liver. And we prayed and believed, and because I believe it's God's will for us to be made whole.
God will-